In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Today, we bring to completion our long journey. Is that right, completion?
Yeah.
I asked Fernando this morning, are you nervous? And he said, no. He said, I'm just happy. He said, Lucretia made her communion, she got her sacraments, and he said, all of this just came together, huh? And what did I tell you? Who is good? God is good, huh? So today, with all of our love and support for both of them and their family, let's give them a round of applause.
A reading from the book of Genesis. The Lord said, it is not good for the man to be alone. I will make up a suitable partner for him. So the Lord God formed out of the ground various wild animals and various birds of the air. And he brought them to the man to see what he would call them. Whatever the man called each of them would be its name. Man gave the name to all the cattle, all the birds of the air, and all the wild animals. But none proved to be the suitable partner for the man. So the Lord God cast a deep sleep on the man, and while he slept, he took out one of his ribs and closed it up its place with flesh. The Lord God then built up into him a woman, the rib that he had taken from the man. When he brought her to the man, the man said, this one, at last, is the bone of my bones and the flesh of my flesh. This one shall be called woman, for out of her man, from out of her man, this one has been taken. This is why a man leaves his father and mother and clings to his wife, and the two of them become one body. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Let us stand for our gospel. You will live in my love if you keep my commandments.
even as I have kept my Father's commandments and live in his love. All this I tell you, that my joy may be yours and your joy may be complete. This is my commandment, love one another as I have loved you. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated just for a moment. You know, right, Akisha and Fernando, before the wedding, right, a couple weeks before I gave you a book, right, with all of the readings in and remember everything else, and we kind of went through my highlight of what you need to look at. They chose the readings, huh? You chose one from Genesis. You chose that very difficult response, you know, that says, what? Blessed the man who greatly delights in the Lord's commands. Huh? Wow. And I thought, Akisha, why did you choose that line? Huh? Did you pick it? Yeah, she picked that. So I kind of sat down and I thought, I wonder what Akisha's thinking about, you know, with all of this. And I chose my gospel based on where we talk about commands and commandments. And I thought about a wedding cake. You got a wedding cake? How many tears? What is there? I was thinking about a three-tiered or layered wedding cake. And I say that because it came to mind today, because there's three key words that stand out in the remarks on Fernando that Jesus just made to his disciples and to all of us in the Gospel from John. You want to take a stab at one of those key words, Lucretia? Might be what? I said it earlier. Commands, that's one. Those three key words, Fernando and Lucretia, make up three essential parts of the marriage contract that you and Fernando will soon sign, seal, and deliver to each other on your wedding day. And those three words are, in this order, love, did you hear that? Commandments, and the last one is joy. Joy. Those are the three key words. And Jesus, in this gospel that we just heard from John, he speaks first of love. The love he knows his Father has for him, the love that Jesus has for his disciples, and the love that his followers are to have for one another. And then Jesus speaks of commandments. His Father's commandments that Jesus himself, we're told, has kept for his entire life. And then Jesus speaks of the commandments that he wants us to keep as his followers. And last of all, Jesus speaks of joy, the joy that he wants us to have, and our joy that he desires to be complete. Huh? There it is. There it is. You want to hear the gospel one more time? It's short. You want to hear it? Just to make sure you didn't miss them? You want to hear it again, you guys? Let's listen. Jesus said to his disciples, as the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Live on in my love. If you keep my commandments, even as I have kept my Father's commandments and live in his love. All this I tell you, that my joy may be yours and your joy may be complete. This is my commandment, love one another
as I have loved you. Did you see them all night, guys? Just like a three-tiered wedding cake. Right? Now, love, commandments, and joy. This is the eternal triangle on which the marriage of Fernando and Lakeisha begins and continues. They are the obvious and basic ingredients of a successful and happy marriage relationship. And it's particularly important right here for all of us to note the order. The sequence of these three key words needs to be noticed. Love first, joy last, commandments are in between. That's the way Jesus lays it out. Now, the commandments of the Lord are going to be the bridge. They are the link that unites, you know, you, Fernando, you, Lakeisha, in love and joy that you're only beginning to experience today. Okay, bring her to Dad. You can bring her to Dad. Bring her over to Dad. Oh, see, she's grandma. She'll take care of her. Grandmas are supposed to do that. Anyway, let's go back. Commandments. That's the bridge. And I think if the commandments are overlooked, or if they're forgotten or ignored, then the love and joy is simply going to begin to fall apart, and it's going to drift further and further apart. And it's important that Fernando and Lakeisha not only promise to love one another, not only promise to find joy in each other, but they also promise to honor and obey both the Lord's commandments as well as each other. Remember the marriage vows. So what are the Lord's commandments, huh? In case you say, okay, Father, tell me, what are the Lord's commandments? You know, they're the basic laws of God that all of us are called to follow. And that is, we are to honor God first above all things, and not idols of our own making, such as money and power and position or prestige. We are to respect the holy name of God, aren't we, Fernando? We are to keep holy the Lord's Day as a very special time for praising God's goodness, huh? And asking God's continued help in our lives. That's why it's important, you know, to be at Mass, huh? Be at Mass. And we are to honor our parents. Even though marriage, in the first reading, convocation, we're told that's the reason why a man leaves his father and mother, right? And the two became one. We are to honor parents, even though marriage draws this couple away from father and mother to begin their own family. To respect life in every phase of existence, from conception to death, to respect and use the gift of sex as a privilege and a responsibility, not as a plaything or something to control another person or a blind passion. And we are to respect the life and property of others, huh? Sounds like the Ten Commandments to me, doesn't it? And we got them where, you guys? Fernando, you got to take the kids out there and show them one time. So we're out in front of church. Huh?
You know, to these ancient and very honored commandments that God gives through Moses, there are other commands that Jesus himself gives us in the gospel, such as love your enemies, pray for those who persecute you. If you forgive others the wrongs they have done, your Father will forgive you also. Don't worry about tomorrow, Malachi. It'll have enough worries of its own. Do not judge others so that God will not judge you. And ask and you will receive, and seek and you will find, and knock and it will be open to you. And one last one, come and follow me. And Jesus, you know, he does a favor for us today by summing up all of his Father's and his own commandments into one single command. And remember what that was, Ephesians, the last line of the gospel. We are to love one another as he, Jesus, has learned us. Fernando and Lakeisha, you should never forget that command. Loving each other as Jesus loves each of you is a never-ending privilege and responsibility. And there is never a time when Jesus gets tired of loving you or any one of us. Never. And you know something? The love of Jesus that he speaks about, it's not a moonlight and roses kind of thing. Sorry. It doesn't dim, you know, when the clouds cover the moon or when the roses begin to wilt. Look at the cross of Christ. We got a big one in St. John's. No one in Santa Fe has that size, huh? Look at the cross of Christ. Learn and relearn the height and the depth and the length and the breadth of Jesus' life. His is a love that never says die. His is a love that doesn't count the cost or keep a list. His is a love that keeps loving no matter what, no matter how much it hurts. This is the command of love that Jesus has for us and for one another. So, I want to give you a gift. Can it be your first wedding? Fernando, come over to the kitchen. Each other and their joy in each other is always going to grow stronger and improve with age. Today would have been my mother and father's, are you ready for this, 70th wedding anniversary. 70 years. I think our prayer for them this day is that their marriage will be a living witness to the simple secret that Jesus has shared with all of us this wedding day. And that is to keep a marriage in love, joy, and obey the commands of God. And obey the command of Jesus. And obey each other. Just not today, but all the days of your life. You are prayed for. Bring the kids. I'm not afraid of love. And I love you. You should be prepared. Know that this is your home. When you walk in here, there it is. When you walk into your own home, put it where you can see it. And remember how much God loves you. That's the love we share with one another. Amen.
Amen. My dear friends, you have come together in this church so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of the church's ministers in this community. Christ abundantly blesses this love. He has already consecrated you both in baptism, and now he enriches and strengthens you by a special sacrament so that you may continue assuming the duties of marriage in mutual and in lasting fidelity. And so in the presence of the church, I ask you both to save your intentions. Fernando and Leticia, have you come here freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage? Yes. Will you love and honor each other as man and wife for the rest of your lives? Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church? Since it is your intention to enter into marriage, join your right hands and declare your consent before God and his church. I, Fernando, take you, Leticia, to be my wife. I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health. I will love you and honor you all the days of my life. I, Leticia, take you, Fernando, to be my husband. I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health. I will love you and honor you all the days of my life. You have declared your consent before the church. May the Lord in his goodness strengthen your consent and fill you both with his blessing. What God has joined, we must not divide. Amen. Lord, bless Fernando and Leticia in their love for each other. May these rings be a symbol of true faith in each other and always remind them of their love through Christ our Lord. Leticia, take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Fernando, take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. I guess there's only one thing left to do, and I hope it matches, and give your new bride a kiss, huh? Let's give them a round of applause.
And we pray that world leaders and national leaders may promote
what is necessary for a strong and stable family life in our society. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we pray that day by day, Fernando and Lukisha will grow ever stronger in bonds of love and fidelity. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we pray that this marriage of Fernando and Lukisha will be a blessing for their families and their friends and for all their neighbors. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we pray that God will assist all married couples and give them joy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we pray for all of us who are gathered here, that we will be filled with the spirit of love and respect, kindness and generosity, patience and forgiveness. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our
prayer. And we pray for all deceased members of our families, especially the deceased members of Fernando and Lukisha's family, that they and all of our faithfully departed may be taken and drawn up into the kingdom of heaven. Let us pray to the Lord. Loving God, you are the author of marriage, and so we ask you to watch over married couples, especially Fernando and Lukisha. May each day of married life bring them closer to you because of your continuing guidance and care. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
You may be seated.
Just as your goodness is its origin.
so that the chaste and fruitful love of holy matrimony may serve to increase the children you adopt as your own. By your providence and grace, O Lord, you accomplish the wonder of this twofold design, that while the birth of children brings beauty to the world, their rebirth in baptism gives increase to the church through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Through him, the angels, and all the saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please hear. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the Father of all holiness. May holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister through you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and John Wesley, our Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the Blessed Apostles, our patron, St. John the Baptist, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be equal heirs to eternal and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Please stand. At the Savior's command, informed by the Bible, dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy
right hand in blessing for Fernando and Nikisha. Holy Father, creator of the universe, maker of man and woman in your own likeness, source of blessing for married life, we humbly pray to you for this woman, who today is united with her husband in the sacrament of marriage. May your fullest blessing come upon her and her husband, so that they may together rejoice in your gift of married love and enrich your church with their children. Lord, may they both praise you when they are happy and turn to you in their sorrows. May they be glad that you help them in their work and know that you are with them in their need. May they pray to you in the community of the church and be your witnesses in the world. And may they reach all the company of their friends and come at last to the kingdom of heaven. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant you peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
Amen.
Let's share a sign of peace with each other.
Simply come like
my first recording, I'll give you a blessing.
Okay?
For the rest of us who receive, if you receive by hand, remember it's one palm on top of the other. As you stand for the Eucharist, I'll say the body of Christ, you make the slight bow of your head, and then it'll be placed right in your hand, pick up immediately and put it in your mouth. And for the rest, you receive by mouth again. As you stand before the Eucharistic minister, they will say, body of Christ, you make the slight bow of your head, and then you speak on your tongue. At this time, I would invite those who are to receive communion and those who wish a blessing to perform our two traditional communion lines.
Thank you.